I guess, like, you know, time goes by quick. That's what they tell us. We believe you're already here.
I mean, yeah, it was definitely a lot faster than I thought it was. I remember, like, when I first went off to college, my mom telling me it's going to be the best 4 years of your life.
Coach was telling us that Tyler's going to play tomorrow. Just your thoughts on that? We've been here with him this whole time. It's just after seeing him coach, what's the deal for him to get that opportunity?
When the coach first said it, I started smiling because I actually known Tyler for a long time since he was 13. And, I know how great of a player he was. He probably recruited out of high school, committed to Duke. He committed and came to Georgetown. That was kind of because of me. I came here. And like, this is a big moment for him. A lot of people haven't been able to see Tyler play. I think it's going to be a good game. His career with Georgetown uniform on, saying his name on the back of his jersey.
So, how good a player was he? That people may not know about.
I mean, he was committed to Duke, so that's
yeah. He came here. He's, what's he done for you guys over his career?
Like, how's he helped with the program? His love for the game is tremendous. He's always been out here on the bench, telling us what he sees out on the court, what he do. He's kind of turned into a coach, being around the coaches on their level. So he knows the type of things that the coaches want out of us, and then he has a connection with us actually being our teammate. But he has a better way of like explaining that to us.
Do you remember how well he handled the diagnosis and sort of how talking to him about it seems to take it in a very positive way? Do you remember those days back then and how he was able to sort of move on quickly from that?
Yeah, when it first happened, it wasn't like he's done. Right off the back, I think he had this whole process of getting the pacemaker, trying to play with that. And then after a while, I think his mind was just completely shut him down, because like, your health is more important than basketball at the end of the day. And we didn't want to have an incident like that, somebody collapsing on the court at Georgetown. So like, I feel as though that's how the process went.
Talk about your journey from way back in the day, squash all beats, eventually the triple threat, to Matha and now. How have you developed as a player and a person?
A lot. I've grown a lot. I learned a lot more about the game. When I first started off, I wasn't that good. But I continue to work. I was blessed to go to a great high school and then come to a great university like Georgetown. I think it built me and shaped my character.
What is Squash and Takeover? I know the different organizations. What have they done to help you?
They've always been in my corner. Just being home, having those guys and support, I can always call people when I'm not doing so well in school or not playing as well as possible. I go talk to those guys, ask them what they see, what should I work on. Then they have a relationship with the coaches, so they can talk to the coaches and see what they need out of me and what I should work on.
Anything else from Mikhail?
In terms of seeing all the challenges and different, how are they different?
One less shooter, and Delgado still a tremendous rebounder, so we just have to keep him on the board.
Awesome. Thanks, Kel.